Hello! So today I'm doing a video on my top 10 Frank Sinatra movies. And I'm doing this today because I've been planning to do a Frank Sinatra video for a long time. Because if nobody knows, Frank Sinatra was the one person I liked way back when I was a baby. But I always liked Frank Sinatra. Right next to Andy Williams, Frank Sinatra used to be my number one favorite person when I was a little kid. So, yeah. Number 10 is On the Town.
Sorry, no more fares today. I'm turning in the cab. It's overdue.
Oh, please, mister. Hey, he's a girl. What are you doing driving a cab? The war's over.
I never give up anything I like. Get in.
The subway station.
Huh? It's right over there. You 2 weeks to walk it?
No, the next one uptown.
Oh, all right. But only if he gets up front.
Because I think it's a cute little movie, and it goes along with Anchors Away. Early Frank Sinatra movie, and he was cute and young in this, but I also like this movie because I said the part with him and the taxi cab girl, him and the taxi cab girl are so cute together, even though she's like meant to be an annoying hobo, she's actually cute.
Let's go to my place,
go to Rubens,
go to my place,
go to Macy's,
go to my place,
go to Roxy's,
go to my place,
Cloisters, Gimbel, Flatiron, Building, Camp Cajon,
my place.
Just watch a movie and you would see why. But anywho's, that is why On the Town is number 10.
That's all there is, folks, so good night to you. We hope you like a little Shanghai review.
Number 9 is The Man with the Golden Arm.
All right, so let him sit there, but at least he could talk to her once in a while. He doesn't have to sit there with his nose buried in a magazine. I would talk to her.
What would you say?
Well, I'd say, how you been? How did it go today? What's for supper?
Steak. Steak's for supper, and everything went fine today.
Steak? Good.
Because it has Kim Novak, and she was always so cute. But she was younger, and because this hilarious attempt at dramatics. Like, I know this is the 1950s, and they were just starting with getting more serious dramatic movies, but are you kidding me? These dramatics. And I like this movie because the dramatics are so funny. It's like one of those movies that is so horrendous that you're laughing because it's so funny. It's funny that it's so horrendous. But so, yeah. Oh my gosh, and the plot twist with his crusty girlfriend in this. I think her name was Zosh. Yeah, her name is Zosh. The plot twist with his girlfriend, I'm dying. Oh my gosh. Even though I knew she was lying this whole movie, but you just have to watch the movie to see. So I don't spoil the plot. Just go watch the movie and you'll see.
I stood right up, I walked right over, and I put him there, all right?
No, no kidding.
Maybe by when she was straightening up for me. I don't know. Stop picking on me.
Number 8 is Miracle of the Bells.
It was a $90 funeral, not $100. She told me. She paid you $10, that leaves $80. Give me $20.
Oh, no, oh, no. What about the extras? The flowers for the grave and pallbearers at $2 apiece out of my own pocket. I'm a respectable businessman, Mr. Dunnigan. I never cheated nobody in my life. And when I say $100, it's $100.
Now, Frank Sinatra is a literal newborn in Miracle of the Bells. But this is a cute movie, and it's not so much really focused on Frank Sinatra, this movie, but it's focused on this man and his girlfriend. And she was in, what was she in? She was in Joan of Arc, and he wants people to bury her. And basically, Frank Sinatra is like the priest of one of the churches in the town, and he's like supposed to be a non-corrupt priest because all the other priests are corrupt because they only want money and they don't really care about the man or his raggedy girlfriend, and they're like, are you gonna pay us or not? And he's like, well, I don't have any money, and they're like, oh, well then. And Frank Sinatra is the one that's like, well, I'll do whatever for her because I don't need money in this net.
How much for you?
For me? I too am used to not being paid, Mr. Dunnigan, and I'd rather not break the precedent. I'm very proud that this girl wanted to be buried for my church. To a humble priest, that's a great satisfaction.
So basically, that's the whole movie, the man trying to get the people to understand why his girlfriend is special. So that's why Miracle of the Bells is number 8.
Oh, I
pig on you both. I'm finished. I quit. I go back to the theater. No more here. No more.
Number 7 is Young at Heart.
I know it.
Oh, what do you got here? Chicken, huh? Hmm. Diane and the White Knight, they're home early.
So basically, it's like these three sisters, or is it two sisters? I haven't watched in a long time, so I don't remember. It's either three sisters or two sisters, but it's like a love triangle. Yeah, it's just a love triangle. And this one part will never fail to enrage me to the highest leveling degree. The girl is making gingerbread cookies, and the person who Frank Sinatra plays, she kept trying to get him to be happy the whole movie, because the whole movie, it's like he was mad at the world, and she was like, why are you like this? Be happy. Stop being mad and hating everybody. Okay, so she's mixing up the cookie batter, and she gets the spoon, and she's like, lick the spoon, and I was like, all in anticipation, and then he just like was like, no.
All I know is that there's a straitjacket waiting for you with your number on it. Lick the spoon.
I hate this movie. So, but also because the movie has a decent plot and the little baby is cute that they have at the end. So that is why Young at Heart is in there.
Barney, why are you going to New York? Just because I'm getting... Well, it's still no reason why I have to stop trying to make a human being out of you. Hey, I'm the girl who brought chintz curtains into your life, remember? And I'm not going to stop...
Why do you have to look so beautiful?
Number 6 is The Manchurian Candidate, which I still don't know if I'm saying that right, but... Oh well.
He saved our lives and took out a complete company of Chinese infantry.
A complete company? What the hell is this?
So, anyways, The Manchurian Candidate, if you know, like, is one of those iconic historical films that they always show. And then one day I decided to watch it and I was like, oh yeah, Frank Sinatra's in this. So, let's see. It's basically about mind control and brainwashing, and basically I can't say that much because then the plot will be exposed, but oh my goodness, at the end of this plot, I'm just like, well, somebody hates their parents. But while the movie is going along, we keep seeing that the soldiers have these dreams, and they think they're dreams at least, but they're not dreams, they're actually what was happening to them when the man was brainwashing them. And, so, yeah. That's basically all I can say about The Manchurian Candidate as far as, like, the plot goes without exposing it too much. But it's a good movie, so go watch it.
I am not lovable. Some people are lovable, and other people are not lovable. I am not lovable.
Number 5 is The Detective.
I want a bookend.
For what?
Go on.
Yeah, go on. Oh! Oh!
Oh. Nestle, you're a miserable son of a bitch.
Yes, sir.
So basically, in The Detective, it's like 500 different plots mixed together. One plot is Frank Sinatra trying to find out if this boy is guilty or not of killing, I don't know if you want to say his boyfriend, because I don't know if the man, not really his boyfriend, but like, I don't know what you would call this man. I guess you call him the man. He's guilty of killing the man. He's trying to figure out if the boy's guilty of killing the man. He's trying to figure out why his wife slash girlfriend is such a raggedy hobo. And he's caught up in trying to leave the police because the police are such a corrupt force. But that's why The Detective is number 5.
You know about the drug thing? I'd like to tell you about it.
You needn't.
Number 4 is Robin and the Seven Hoods.
Listen, what are you doing here? I thought you was down in New Orleans. You was doing so good down there.
Who hit Big Jim?
Hit who?
Him.
Geez, you're looking good. You know, would you put on a little weight? What's the matter with you? Give the man a seat. Get up.
All right, Gisborne, who hit him?
What's the difference who hit him? The man is dead. Forget about it.
Because this is such a good movie. This movie is up there with Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band, and as far as my favorite movies of all time. Didn't anybody- Okay, so basically, a tiny synopsis is, at the beginning, I forget because there are too many of them have a different name. Let me think. I think it's Guy Gisborne that's still alive. Yeah, he's the one that plotted. Yeah, the one at the beginning, which I was like, this is what I knew was going to happen when I first seen this movie. There's this man called Big Jim, and all the rest of the mobsters throw him a birthday party. And they're all like, wait, before you go away or give your toast, we have one last thing to say. And I'm like, of course it was a setup. Of course it was a setup. He was so stupid for coming to the birthday party in the first place. If you're going to deal with ghetto people, never go anywhere they invite you, because, like, what is wrong with you?
Wait a minute. Before you all get drunk, a toast to Big Jim on his birthday. Now, come on, let's hear it. To Big Jim.
Happy birthday, Big Jim. Anyways, so basically the whole movie is Robbo and Guy Gisborne trying to, I guess, outdo each other as who runs the city. This movie is just so funny. Plus, it has good songs in it. So, yeah, that is why Robin and the Seven Hoods is number four.
Somehow I get the feeling I'm being had.
Had?
Yeah, nudged.
Nudged?
It's an old Italian word. I'll tell you about it another time.
You misunderstand, Robbo. You can take over this town. I just want to help.
When I want yours or anybody else's help, I'll ask for it.
You want to be a two-bit bicycle thief all your life?
Big Jim's daughter. There's a big laugh. I bet when you were a kid, you didn't have a doll to play with. You had a rattler. It was right on the end of your tail. You like it, Doc?
Number three is Ocean's 11.
Well, put this in your pipe. One of these days, I'll break your back. I swear it.
It's a good thing for you she doesn't pack a knife.
How do you know she doesn't?
When they're like, recommend movie. Ocean's 11, the original, not the remake, because the remake is trash. And the thing is, the thing is that gets me about the Ocean's 11, the new Ocean's 11 with Brad Pitt, Bernie Mac, I think Matt Damon's in this, I can't remember, Don Cheadle, I think, and some other people I can't remember, is that fake English accent. Jesus Christ, I hate when people have such a fake accent. I can't take when people cannot do other accents good. Like, if you're not good at faking other accents, then don't fake other accents. This is worse than David Bowie doing an American accent, and I just, oh my God, my ears are bleeding. Like, I died watching this movie. It was so hideous. Jesus Christ. But anyways, so that's why I like the original Ocean's 11. One, the songs are good. Two, the plot is good. Three, you get to see the vintage Las Vegas and Arizona area, how it looked before they renovated it and fixed it up like it is now. So that is why Ocean's 11 is a good movie. And you should just watch the original Ocean's 11 to see why it's so good, because I don't want to be like 111 plot spoiler, so just watch it and you'll see why it's good.
You should be ashamed of yourself enticing a broken arm man into a project of such precision.
You know what your problem is? You underestimate people. Louis, grab it.
What? What's that with a broken arm?
Why, shucks, Mr. Seedless, it's all healed now.
Number two is Some Came Running.
Say, pal, will you get it for me? Pint of O'Legal up there. Very cool day tonight. Real nice stuff.
Anybody ever tell you whiskey's a man's drink? Why don't you run home to mama?
Because, one, Shirley MacLaine is really, really cute, and this is a good movie. Well, basically the plot is, Shirley MacLaine is basically following Frank Sinatra because he used to be a writer and he was supposed to be so famous. And she followed him when he got off the Greyhound. And, but the thing is, her old crusty boyfriend never, got unattached from her. So he followed her into this town and the next town and the next town and the next town. He kept following her and he was like after her this whole time, but she didn't care about him. She wanted to be with Frank Sinatra.
Look, Sylvia, you slugged me in Chicago when I wasn't looking. Now blow, I'll wipe the floor with your uniform.
Not only would that be unpatriotic, but you might get hurt.
I'm just reminded, this is my girl.
Are you?
Raymond, will you please cut it out?
No, I'm not his girl. I'm not his anything. He bought me a couple of drinks.
Yeah, what about the coat?
You want it back?
Just give me a chance.
There's your chance. Go ahead, take it. But remember the squirt in the cellar.
Oh, wait a minute. I've had enough of this horsing around. I'm not going anywhere until I find out what's what. I'm beginning to believe that you've never had any intentions at all of producing Godspeed. Why, Glenn, how could you say that? And furthermore, if you haven't, I want my play and my money right now, or I'll speak to my uncle.
Joe, get back in bed. Joe, don't. You're gonna hurt yourself. Joe, don't. Joe, stop it, Joe.
We're the wishing well. I wish that we were there together.
And now on to number one, Guys and Dolls. For so many reasons I cannot name Guys and Dolls. It's the best movie ever. The best Frank Sinatra movie, one. Well, if I have to explain why Guys and Dolls is such a good movie. The songs are good. The color is good. The outfits are good. Everything is good. Adelaide is really cute. Her character is cute. All the girls that dance with her. And this song, even for nowadays, this song is doing a bit much. The little kitty cat song, I'm like... Okay.
If you don't want me out roaming the city, talk to me pretty. Kitty, kitty, and pet me, papa, papa, pet me good. Ooh, pet me, papa, papa, pet me good. Ooh, pet me, papa, proper, like you should.
And also the song Adelaide is such a good, amazing song. All the songs in, Guys and Dolls are good, except for the ones that girl who's supposed to be a church girl sings, and the one that Marlon Brando sings, but the rest of them are good. So, yeah, that is why Guys and Dolls is in there, because it's a beautiful, wonderful, amazing movie, and everybody should watch Guys and Dolls.
When you wind up in jail, don't come to me to bail you out.
All right, already, so call a policeman. All right, already, it's true, so new, so sue me. What can you do me? I love you.
So thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.